Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name's Tamlyn and this is Sewn on the Tyne. And I'm here today with a bit of a bumper Friday Sews catch up, which is really a haul, mainly from the Stitch Festival, but also a few other bits that I have been picking up here and there. Should we start off with what I'm wearing? I'm wearing the Sew Over at Florence dress. I haven't actually shared this yet. I'll be sharing it in my makes and favorites video, which will be out in a week or so. And I actually made this for a funeral. So it was a funeral of a really special friend of ours. And I wanted to make something really special because she had a wonderful dress sense, always wore beautiful dresses and things. And I wanted to wear something as a tribute to her. So I made the Sew Over at Florence dress in this incredible fabric, which is from Cloth Edit, in one of their Club Cloth Edit boxes, which is like a quarterly box of beautiful fabric and other bits and bobs. So this was in the last one and it's just incredible. So yes, should I stand up and just show you this? I don't want to go into loads of detail because I'll be sharing it in my makes video, but I know you'll probably want to see it, so hold on. And on my mannequin as well, because some people will probably wonder what that is. It looks a bit random at the minute. This is my current work in progress, which is the Jenna shirt by Closet Core. And it's made in this lovely cotton poplin, which was from Hey So Sister. It's one of their exclusive designs. I think Pigeon Wishes printed it for them, but it's just so fun and I love it. And I've sent photos over to Rowan and Rachel today of my progress and they've both said they now want the same fabric. So we may all be twinning at some point. So the Stitch Festival, I mean, you may all be sick of hearing about it because I guess so many people have put out videos sharing their experiences, which I have loved watching. I've loved seeing everybody's experiences of the amazing weekend that was the Stitch Festival in London. It was the first time I'd been, myself and the girls, we went down together. We traveled down on the Friday and then we went to the actual Stitch Festival on the Saturday. I loved it. I really loved it. However, next year I would definitely have to go for 2 days, like 2 full days at the festival. There's so much that I feel like we missed, like watching everybody's videos and I'm like, oh, we didn't do that, we didn't see that, we didn't go there, I feel like we missed out on a lot. So we were there from like 9:30 in the morning till 5:30 in the evening. We went out for lunch in the middle, so we lost a couple of hours there, but we were there for the full day. But because we were talking to so many people, which was amazing and wonderful, we didn't actually get to do any of the other things. So we didn't see any of the catwalk shows or the talks. We didn't do any workshops. And I don't feel like we saw all of the stalls. And the stalls that we did see, I don't feel like we saw all of the things that they had to offer. So although it was an incredible experience and I loved it, I feel like I didn't do everything or see everything that I could have. So next year, absolutely, we'll be going for 2 full days. I feel like that's needed. If you want to do a lot of the social aspect of it and meeting people and chatting to people, I feel like you need more time to then include the other stuff as well. But yes, it was an incredible weekend, met lots of wonderful people, some of whom I've met before, some of whom I haven't, and it was just a blast. I loved it all. So thank you if you came up and spoke to me or us, and yeah, let's do it all again very soon. So what did I actually pick up from the Stitch Festival? So we started out at Ethel and Joan, and I just love Ethel and Joan. So Louise, who runs that business, it's her baby, and she's just grown and grown, and her products have just evolved, and her range has evolved, and so yes, we went there first, basically. I think it was Rowan who was like, Tamlyn, you need to see these earrings because they are a bit of you. And she wasn't wrong. So I had to buy them. They're just glorious, aren't they? So these incredible pastel acrylic, like, no, they're not hearts, Tamlyn, come on. They're flowers, but they're just so beautiful. So yes, I got myself those. I think she only had 2 pairs, so I just got them straight away. There was no like thinking about it. It's just like, gotta have them. And I also picked up some buttons, which are actually to use on my Jenna shirt. So that shirt is covered in little flowers of lots of different cute colours. So I got these buttons, which I thought would be a perfect match. I took a little scrap of the fabric along with me because I knew I needed to pick up some buttons, and these were the ones. We then popped to see the gorgeous Victoria from Little Rosy Cheeks, who designs the most fun labels. I adore them. I have nearly all of them, but she did have some new ones that I had to pick up. And she also does sewing patterns as well. So I picked up a couple of labels which I don't have. And one, I think everybody's YouTube video that I've watched, everybody picked up these same labels. So they are the Swing It, Shake It, Move It, Made It, which is obviously a Spice Girls reference, but in a really fun like neon pink with, is it like neon yellow at the bottom. So love those ones. And then these lovely handmade, I've had these in the other colorways. She's brought out a few different colorways now, but I love these like coral and green versions here. So I got those two. She had an offer on for like three packs for a certain price. So I was trying to find a third pack. And then Ruan was like, I'm just going to get two packs because that's all I want. And I was like, yeah, I'm going to do the same. But don't you do that thing when you go to like a shop or a supermarket and there's a special offer on, like 3 for 2. So you're like, oh, I have to get three. But actually, maybe you don't need or want three. So yes. Anyway, I got two. And then she popped in this lovely free label as well, which says, I made this. So yes, that was the second stop on our little trip. Then there were loads of gorgeous like embroidery and cross stitch and that sort of stalls. And actually, I really wanted a cross stitch kit. The one that I found that I loved was sold out. And then at the end of the day, I was going to go back around and choose a different one, but we ran out of time because we headed to the Prosecco bar and got chatting to people. So anyway, we went to a lovely little stall, which was Kate Blandford. So I had spotted her on Instagram in the weeks running up to Stitch Festival, and I knew I wanted to check out her stand. So she does contemporary cross stitch. I don't need another needle minder, but I got this one because it was just adorable. So it's like a crescent moon with a little bat hanging in it. I mean, it's just lovely. And then this, which is for storing your embroidery floss. So you tie it, the different colours, through these little flower shapes here. And then these little slots here are for popping in the label from the thread so you know what colour it is. I mean, clever or what? I just thought that was really cute, and I loved the glitter in that as well. And you know what? I've only actually got two other things from the Stitch Festival. So, oh no, three. Three things. So we popped next to Fabric Godmother, and I didn't really look at all of the fabric, but I saw her new range like hanging up, and then she had garments made up in the new fabrics. So that was the weekend that she launched her spring summer collection for this year, and there was one that just really sang to me. I really loved it. It's a viscose crepe, and I picked up 3 meters, but actually I've got about 3.5 because there was a fault near the selvedge on the fabric at the start where I think it had just got caught on the shelving. The same happens at First with Fabrics, like the fabric can get caught on a shelf and just pulls a little bit. So that's what happened to this one, and I spotted it thankfully, and I just said, oh, would you mind just starting the measurement after that? So that's what they did. So I've definitely got some extra that I can use. Yeah, I've got a nice big chunk of this one. And it's this design, which I just absolutely loved. Is that the right way up? Let's see. There we go. So it's a black and like ecru or cream design. They've got this in a couple of different colours. I think they've got a really like vibrant, is it pink and something? But I just love this one. I thought it was really classic. So it's lovely and drapey with it being a viscose. It's got a little bit of texture with it being a crepe. And my initial thoughts were that I wanted to make a two-piece out of this, maybe a little shirt and some elasticated waist trousers, something like the Tamarama set by Swim Style Patterns. Then I started to question myself, but you know what? I think I've gone back to that vision in my head. I can just see that being gorgeous for the summer. So yes, that is going to be a cord, like two-piece set. Love that one. Oh, and I got a lovely little tote bag from them as well, which is great. Always love getting a tote bag. And I was served by Fauve from the last season of The Sewing Beast. That was lovely as well. Then I got one more piece of fabric, and it was one that I desperately wanted after seeing, I think it was What Abby Makes on Instagram had shared this in her story, so she picked it up on the Thursday, I think she was there. I screenshotted it straight away, sent it to Ruan and Rachel and said I have to get that same fabric. So the fabric was from Pigeon Wishes. They had this in a few different colorways. Lovely little bag again. And I just had to have this one though because I loved it. I mean, it actually goes with my nails. Come on. So this is a cotton twill. So it's just a lovely canvas sort of fabric, like a denim. Just a lovely sturdy cotton with the twill weave in it. And it's this black and, again, ecru checkerboard. And I want to make the new Sew Over It Xanthi skirt out of this. So that was my final purchase of the day, actually. I went to the Sew Over It stand and I got a printed copy of the Xanthi skirt. So their patterns are PDF only, but they had loads of their patterns printed out on A0 and available at the Stitch Festival. So I think you get the instructions emailed to you, if I remember rightly. So you get the printed out pattern there. So that is going to be the Xanthi skirt and I'm very excited about it. Alma, who works for Sew Over It, she was wearing the Xanthi skirt in the purple version of this fabric and it just looked incredible. And I thought, I need to have that in my life. So that's what that will be. So that is my Stitch Festival haul. I mean, I think that's very mild, isn't it? But I do have quite a few other things to share with you. So the other thing I came home with from that weekend was this gorgeous cross stitch kit, which was a gift from Ruan and Rachel. So the weekend before, they had been to the Creative Craft Show, Sewing for Pleasure. I think it's the same thing, but it's called different names. They bought this for me from Becky's Sewing Studio and it's just gorgeous. It's a lovely lightning bolt cross stitch kit. They knew I would love this and they were right, and I really appreciate the gift, so thank you so much, girls. I can't wait to get started on that. And then I'm going to show you this fabric which arrived today, which is Stitch Festival related. So I was watching Amelia Ellen Sews, who is just gorgeous, and I love watching her, and she's so lovely in real life as well. I saw her at the Stitch Festival and I was watching her roundup of the Stitch Festival, and she shared this fabric that she had bought from Rainbow Fabrics. Now, we went to Rainbow Fabrics, but I think it was towards the end of the day. We didn't have much energy by that point. We had been out the night before, you know, for a bit of fun. So we were getting a bit tired, a bit jaded by this point. I don't think I really looked at the fabrics, so I didn't see this at all. But Amelia shared it on her video and I was like, wow, I love that. So this is, I think it was a modal viscose. So they uploaded loads of new fabrics the other day that they'd had at the Stitch Festival, and this was one of them. So I snapped it up straight away. I think it sold out straight away though. When I bought my 2 meters, there was only 4 meters left. So I got this and I love it. I'm just going to make a saltwater slip out of this, which may seem boring, but I don't have one in this kind of colour combination. So I think that will be perfect. And it reminds me a bit of the fabric that was in one of the Beyond the Pink Door boxes. It might have even been the very first one. I didn't get it, but Ruan and Andrea from Beyond the Pink Door both made a saltwater in that fabric. And I think it's got a similar vibe to this. It was paisley, definitely. So I'm gonna sort of copy, be inspired by those lovely ladies. So thank you for the inspiration, Amelia, as well. I can't wait to see what you make with yours. Right, I need to get a wriggle on. We've got a taxi coming in about 15 minutes. I'm going to the theatre tonight with my mum. We're going to see Edward Scissorhands, the Matthew Bourne ballet version. And we're going out for dinner first. So I'm really excited, but I need to get a wriggle on. So about 3 weeks ago, Lynn, who is one of my lovely sewtuners, comes along to my socials and is a lovely friend as well. She was going to Jenny Stitches and she said, does anybody want me to bring anything back for them? So I thought, yes. Yes, I do. So I got 2 meters, yeah, 2 meters of this lovely purple cotton twill. I want to make the Tilly and the Buttons Thea trousers with this. It's going to be like my wearable toile version because this was really affordable. I think it was £8 a meter. So I'm going to use this as my first version of that pattern before I then buy the £14 a meter fabric, which I'm eyeing up. So yes, I've got 2 meters of that. Then very on brand for Jenny, isn't it, actually, because Jenny's all about the purple. Then I just spotted two jerseys that I really liked and thought, why not? And I'm going to make myself a little pajama set, I think, out of these. So we've got this one here, which just has all of these little images on. Life is good, love the planet, little smiley flowers, rainbows, roller skates, that sort of thing. So I've got a meter of that one. And then a meter of this striped one that goes with it. And actually they both go really nicely with the purple Thea trouser fabric, the cotton twill. So I'm gonna make the top out of this so then I can wear it with the trousers out and about as well. I'm gonna make shorts out of this fabric for a little pajama set. So thank you, Lynn, for bringing those back for me. It was very kind. Then I'm going to share the fabric that came in the most recent Beyond the Pink Door Think Pink box. So I think everybody should have theirs now, but just in case, skip forward a minute or two. The first thing, I gasped when I opened the box because the first thing that I saw was this incredible travel cup, which I absolutely love. So it's a Beyond the Pink Door travel mug. I mean, how gorgeous is that? I haven't used it yet because I wanted to save it to share with you. And then the fabric was a Nerida Hansen cotton that came in four different colorways. I am over the moon with my colorway. I don't know if Andrea chose this especially for me. I mean, if she did, absolutely hit the nail on the head, because if I'd have got one of the other colorways, I'm not sure I would have loved it so much. I don't think they would have worked for me and my coloring, but this one is perfect because it's got that lovely like vibrant blue as the background. So I've got 2.5 meters. It's a cotton. It's lovely and soft, actually. I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do with it just yet. So if you've got any ideas of what I should make with it, do let me know. But I really, really love it. I love the lilac in these flowers as well. I think it's gorgeous. So yeah, I was very happy with this month's box. Thank you, Andrea. And then the last two fabrics to share with you are from First for Fabrics, where I work, but I bought both of these. I do get a staff discount, which is lovely, but it's just so tempting when new fabric comes in all the time. And this first one was just selling and selling, and I was like, I'm gonna have to get mine before it sells out. So it's a beautiful viscose jersey. And I mean, look at that. Look at the colours in that. It's incredible. So I think I'm just planning a kilo wrap dress, which may seem boring, but I haven't made one of those in ages. So I think that will be gorgeous. I got 2 meters of this and I just love it so much. And then the other one is this, which is a lyocell, which is like a more environmentally friendly version of a viscose. So it's beautifully soft and drapey. It's got a very subtle paisley design, as you can see. And I'm going to make the Anna Allen Anthea blouse in this as part of the Sew April Blouse Challenge, which is being hosted by Gabrielle from Cloth Edit, along with Ruan from the Yorkshire Sew Girl. And I just could really see an Anthea in this. So that's what that is going to become. As we speak, this isn't available on the website, but it will be coming very soon, so don't worry. Right, I need to wrap this up because our taxi is on its way. I just had the little notification. In terms of what I've got coming up this week, planning wise, like what I'm going to be sewing, I've got a couple of Northern Soul Sisters projects to be working on. So I'll link down below our Sew April Blouse video. We're all going to be making a blouse again this year with Cloth Edit fabric. So I'm going to be working on that. I'm just waiting for my patterns to arrive. I've ordered them to be printed, but I think the Easter weekend has just knocked everything back a little bit. So hopefully they might come tomorrow and I can work on them over the weekend. And then I've got another Northern Soul Sisters project to be working on, and I'm going to continue working on my Jenna shirt. So yes, lots to be getting on with. I've got lots of videos coming up soon. I've got my Makes and Favorites video coming up, and that's going to be a bumper one because I didn't film one in February, so I've got February and March makes coming your way, and I'm going to have some April plans coming your way as well, so lots to look forward to. Right, thank you so much for watching today. I hope you've enjoyed today's video and seeing lots of fabrics and things that I've been picking up. I'd love to hear from you down below and let me know which one of those fabrics was your favourite, and if you've got any ideas of what I should make with the Think Pink fabric, the cotton, then please let me know. I'd love some inspiration because I do love that fabric. And I'd like to get it sewn up soon. I hope you're all doing really well, and I'll see you again soon in my next video. Happy sewing. Bye. Where I think it had just been there. I've got hair in my mouth. If you... Oh.